A very good morning to all my dear students. Hope you all are fit and fine. Today, I welcome the students of Standard 7th to the online class of computer. In the previous class, we have already finished our chapter number 2nd. So now we are moving forward to our chapter number 3, that is more on QBasic. So first of all, what is QBasic? So QBasic is one of the versions of Basic. We have already studied about this basic languages, that is Basic and COBOL. So the QBasic is an advanced version of this Basic. It is a simple way to write the programs and create different figures. So with using QBasic, you are able to write the simple or short programs and you are able to create the different figures. So whichever figure you want to create, it is possible creating it using this QBasic programming language. This QBasic programming language is a high-level programming language which is easy, simple to understand and to learn. Okay, so let us start with it. In our previous class, you have learnt about graphics in QBasic, which is a simple way to write programs and create different figures. So in this chapter, you will learn more concepts of programming in QBasic. Before learning these concepts, let's recall what QBasic is and how we start it. Okay, QBasic. So what is QBasic? A QBasic is one of the versions of Basic. QBasic stands for Quick Beginners All Purpose Symbolic Instruction Code. Please underline or remember this full form. Q stands for Quick, B for Beginners, A for All Purpose, S for Symbolic, I for Instruction and C for Code. Okay, so this is the person who are a beginners to learn it very quickly. What to learn? A symbolic instruction code. It means a code which is written using different symbols. Okay, so this is a language which is used to write a symbol or to create an instruction code in a symbolic language. So it is very easy for a beginners and he or she can quickly learn it. Okay, so now let us see some of its features that are listed below. First feature is, it is simple computer language. It is very easy to learn and use. It is high level programming language. It helps us to write, edit and execute the programs. Okay, so first is, it is very simple. It is very easy to learn and to use it. It is high level programming language and it helps you to write anything. After writing, you can edit anything and you can also execute the programs in this QBasic software. Okay, so now let us see how to start the QBasic. Look for the QBasic icon on the desktop and double click on it to start it. First, it is needed that QBasic software must be installed, or QBasic programming language must be installed in your PC. After that, after installing it, you will find an icon of the QBasic on the desktop screen. So first you have to go to that. You have to open your PC. In the desktop, you will find one icon of QBasic. You just have to double click on it and it will get started. When you will open QBasic 4.5, a window 3.1 appears with a welcome message on the screen. The welcome message does not appear in QBasic 7.1. So now we are working with QBasic 4.5 version. The advanced version, that is QBasic 7.1, will not give you a welcome message. Okay, so let us see that what is a welcome message. Welcome to MS-DOS QBasic. Copyright Microsoft Corporation. It means the details about it is given. And a welcome message, it means welcome to the QBasic is given to you. After that, you have to press an escape key on the keyboard to clear that welcome message box. And the following figure, that is 3.1, will appear. Okay, so to escape from the welcome message, you have to press the ESC, that is an escape key on the keyboard. And that welcome dialog box will be vanished. And a new screen will appear in front of you. So this is a screen. Okay, so this screen will appear in front of you. After that, to execute the commands in the QBasic, press F5 or click on the Run menu and select Start option. The output is displayed on the output screen. It means after you have executed your commands, now you want to see the output. Then you have to press the F5 key from the keyboard, or you can use a run option. So here you can see that a run option is given. So you have to use this run option to run your program. And then select the start option. After you have clicked to the start option, the output will be displayed to you on the screen. Let's take a look at the QBasic interface. Okay, so now we are having a look of the QBasic interface. So first is the title bar. You will see the path is displayed. Here the path is displayed. C drive, then say a colon, the A text and the file name. So what is the name of the file? QOX.txt. That is the name of the file. Okay, so in the title bar you will be able to see the name of the file or the language or the QBasic title bar. Okay, after that you will see the menu bar is there. So in the menu bar you will see many options are available. So these are the options which are there on the menu bar. Okay students, can you see these options? File, edit, view, search, run, debug, calls, then Eligatey and options. Okay, these are the options which are available on the menu bar. After that you will find the cursor. So this is a cursor from there where you can begin your writing. Then a programming window is there where you have to write your entire program or your entire code. At last you will see a status bar. Okay, so this is an interface of the QBasic, and this is an immediate window. It means if you have pressed F5, then what you are running or the details about your code or the other programs that you have opened recently will be displayed to you in this immediate window. Now let us see about this all that interface that are of the QBasic. First is title bar. So the title bar display the name of the application. On the right hand side you see three buttons: minimize, maximize and close. Okay, so here you will find three buttons. First is minimize. You can minimize your screen. Here this is a minimize button. You can minimize or shorten your screen. Again you can maximize your screen, and cross button is there to close the window or to cross the QBasic programming software. Then menu bar. So the menu bar is having various options such as edit, view, file, search, run, debug, options and help. Clicking on any of these options will show you the commands under it. Okay, so once you will click on these options, you will find the internal commands in it. Then the programming window. This window is used to type in the codes required for the program. It means what you are writing or what you are creating your program about. So that code you have to write in this programming window. Then status bar. The status bar at the bottom of the screen display the list of shortcut keys to quickly perform QBasic functions. Like to run the program, F5 is the shortcut key. To rename, F2 is the shortcut key. So that all shortcut wheels will be displayed to you at the bottom of the screen in the status bar. After that, cursor. The blinking cursor at the top left corner of the screen indicates where you should start typing. Okay, so where you have to start your typing will be displayed by the cursor. So the cursor will always be at the top left corner of the screen. Then an immediate window. This page shows the immediate execution and output of the print command. It means whenever you are writing the print command, how it will appear or what will be the execution, how it will be displayed in the output. That will be shown in an immediate window. Okay, so this is an interface of the QBasic. Now programming in QBasic, about that, how to write a program, how to run a program, how to save a program, that is a programming in QBasic. About that we will study in our next period. For now, bye bye, have a great day ahead.